Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15 Beta 7. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers. Generally, Apple has been releasing it the next day for public beta testers, so if you're not seeing it by the time of this video, I would expect it tomorrow. Now this came in at 659.3 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized, around 600 megabytes on the iPhone 11 and iPhone 6S Plus. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15 Beta 7 that I have on my 12.9 inch iPad Pro from 2021. They also released tvOS 15 Beta 7 and watchOS 8 Beta 7. However, they did not yet release macOS Monterey Beta 6 or Beta 7. For some reason, we still don't have updates for that, so we're waiting for those. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. Now you can see the build is 19A5337A, and with the A at the end, it means we're getting closer to a final release. Now that does not mean we can't have additional releases with an A at the end or changing the letter, but generally as we see an A, it means we're closer to the final version, and this should be much more stable. So I'm looking forward to that. Now as far as new features or changes, the first thing is there's no new modem update. So if you were having connectivity issues in beta 6, unfortunately, it will probably be the same. However, going from beta 5 to beta 6, it fixed a lot of the connectivity issues I was having, and so far it's been great with beta 6, and hopefully it will be the same with beta 7. So there should be no new modem update, at least on the 12 series phones. Now, as far as new features and changes, I did want to make you aware of one thing, since this isn't specific to this update, but for those of you looking for YouTube picture-in-picture, it's now available if you want to sign up for it and you're a premium subscriber. I showed it in a previous video and I do have it, and some other people have had it on their phones, but if you're not seeing it, you can go to youtube.com/new and then activate it. Now I believe this may be only the US, but some other people around the world have been saying it's working for them as well. So you can turn on experimental features or new features such as picture-in-picture, and then it will activate in your app if you're not seeing it already. So that's a great thing. I just wanted to make you aware of that. Now, as far as the first new changes and features, if we go into Settings and then we go to Display and Brightness, the first thing they've changed is the wallpaper. They've now updated it for iOS 15 in the settings under Display and Brightness. Prior to this, you can see in my left hand is beta 6, in the right is beta 7. It actually showed iOS 14 wallpaper. So they updated it in this version. Unfortunately, they have not brought any new wallpaper into iOS in general. So there's no new changes as far as that yet. Maybe we'll see that with future releases. So that's the first thing they've changed. Also, if you go into Settings and then you go down to Clips, so if you've had an app clip open within 30 days, you'll see this option here. If you do not have it, if you haven't opened an app clip in 30 days, you will not have this option. But if you go into App Clips, and you'll see I have one for Shazam, under Shazam, there's now a cellular data option. This was not there in beta 5. So if we look at beta 5, again, if we go down, you'll see under Clips here, under App Clips, under Shazam, there is no cellular data option. So now you can allow Shazam to access cellular data or App Clips in general. So that's something else new as well. Now, something that's kind of surprising that they did in the previous update is they removed SharePlay. Now, all of the mentions of SharePlay have been removed throughout the OS on the backend code. Thanks to my friend Steve for pointing some of those out as he was searching through the code and looking for more things. So that is gone for now. Hopefully it will be back with iOS 15.1. But another thing they've removed or sort of put into beta now is Private Relay. So if you go under your name in Settings, and once you tap on iCloud, you'll have Private Relay. You'll see now it says beta and it's off by default. Prior to this, I would actually turn this off because it seemed to be quite buggy. So now it's in beta and people can try it out and provide feedback, and it will be in beta for a while. I think this is a good idea since it was very slow and buggy at times. Other times it worked fine, but now having it in beta to fix those issues and hear from feedback seems to make more sense. So I'm glad they're doing that. So that's something they've updated as well. Now, another thing they've updated is if you go into the Watch app, and this is fairly small, and you go into your focus mode for Watch, under focus mode, if you turn off the Mirror My iPhone option, it now says turning on a face for iPhone will not affect your Apple Watch. Before or prior to this, it would actually say Turning off Mirror My iPhone will require you to set up and enable Focus for Apple Watch separately, including Sleep Focus. So they've changed the wording, just made it a little simpler. Once you turn it on, it's basically the same thing. So it says it will also turn it on for Apple Watch. Now it will not affect your Apple Watch. So that's something that they've changed. It's very minor, but it is something they've updated. Now, if we go back to settings, now within settings, if we go to general, under general, if we go down to VPN and device management, tap on that, tap on sign into work or school account, you'll see that some of the wording has changed here as well. So at the bottom, it says learn more and it says email address. On beta 6, it looked a little bit different. It just said email and then had additional wording at the bottom. So this has been updated, just refined as Apple continues to refine iOS 15. Now, another thing I didn't mention in previous updates that was in beta 6 as well is if you go into photos and you take a live photo, prior to this, you would swipe up and what it would do is give you some options for live photos. Instead, they've moved it to the upper left where you can tap on this and then change it to live, loop, bounce, or long exposure. So you can change it and it will update and change accordingly. So you'll see it's a long exposure, so everything's blurry. We can make it bounce, give it just a moment, and it will create a bounce or sort of just a bounce back and forth for social media and then a loop. So it will just continually play in a loop. So those have been updated and brought to the upper left. Very simple, but something that's newer within the last couple of betas. Now, as far as everything new in iOS 15 beta 7, that's it. There's not a whole lot more. There's some wording in health that's changed around cycle tracking, but nothing specific as far as features or additional updates. That means they've continued to refine this more and more. And the same is true with iPadOS. Within iPadOS 15 beta 7, all of the same features are there, all of the same refinements, but no mention of universal control. I've showed you before where you can go into settings under general, go to AirPlay and handoff, and if you turn handoff off and back on, you get options for cursor and keyboard control, similar to that you would get with universal control. However, maybe that's why we haven't seen macOS Monterey beta 6 or beta 7 yet, because they're trying to get this right. Hopefully they keep this in the final version of iOS 15 as it's something many people want and a huge feature for macOS in general with Monterey. So we're waiting for that. So far, there's nothing new there. And it seems like it's a very minor update this time around, but a huge refinement. In fact, there's a bunch of resolved issues as well. There's 7 resolved issues in this update, and some of those have to do with overlapping text that people were seeing throughout the OS. So some people were seeing overlapping text here and there. That's now resolved. VPN apps should now work properly. And even the Bay Bridge will scale correctly at high zoom levels. That means within maps. And so within maps, if we go to the Golden Gate Bridge, some of the scaling wasn't working right. As you scaled in, it wouldn't show properly. That's been fixed in this update. Quite a few small refinements and updates as well. So some of that has been fixed. There is no mention of green tint. However, there's not a single person that told me they have green tint yet. So if you were having that issue with green tint or another issue with raised blacks, again, I haven't heard from anyone that there's an issue with that. It does not mean that there still isn't an issue, but I just haven't heard from anyone yet as far as that goes. Now, there was a Twitter app bug where you would open up Twitter and it would sort of crash and reload. That was fixed initially, but now it's happening again. So when you open it, it sort of flashes on the screen and then crashes and reloads. That has still happened to me on beta 7. It didn't at first, but it is now. Also, banking apps do seem to be working a little bit better if you're using banking apps, but that does not mean they're all working. Mostly German banks still seem to be having issues, so that continues to be an issue, as well as CarPlay. So some people will still have issues with CarPlay. That seems to be manufacturer dependent based on your car, whether that be Toyota, Honda, or something else. So that seems to be really related to them. They may have to upgrade their CarPlay stereos as well. Hopefully not, and hopefully it will be compatible all around, but it could be an issue in the future. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15 beta 8, generally at this point in time, we'll be at a week-to-week cycle throughout August. So on the 17th, we had beta 6. Now on the 25th, we have beta 7. I would expect beta 8 either on the 31st, 1st, or 2nd of September. That's generally what Apple tends to do. So I would expect that, maybe with a release candidate the following week, and then a final version the week after that, sometime around when we expect the next Apple event, where they'll show off the iPhone 13, maybe a new Apple Watch, and more. Maybe they'll have some surprises as well. So maybe the week of the 13th or 12th, we'll have an iOS update along with the new Apple event. So that's really what I'm expecting with that final release. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 15 beta 7 on your phone, if you're on any of the previous betas, I would say absolutely. That's sort of our duty to figure out what's going on and then report it in the feedback app. So if you haven't done that already and you're having specific issues, you'll want to report it in feedback. So the feedback app is provided so you can do that. And then sometimes Apple will get back to you and sort of work with you to get things resolved. Now, if you're not on the beta yet, I would say this is a good time to try it out as long as you have a backup and know that you cannot go back without using a Windows or Mac computer. So you'll need one of those two things in order to go back, whether that be iTunes or Finder. But as long as you have that, or you can bring it to an Apple store, if you're not able to do that, then I would recommend trying it out. Just make sure you have a backup first. It seems to be much more stable at this point. Now, as far as overall battery life, I wanted to share the battery from iOS 15 beta 6, and it does take a few days to figure out what battery life is like. Once it installs, it takes some time to process everything in the background. So if we take a look at my battery health is at 94%. The updates do not reduce battery health, they just recalculate it. This is still at 94, even after installing, it was at that prior to this. We'll look at the last 10 days, and yesterday I had 3 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 42 minutes of screen on off time, and you'll see I used almost 75% of my battery. It varies greatly from day to day as far as overall usage. Some people are getting 10 to 12 hours. I'm getting about 6 to 7 hours. Hopefully it will improve in the future. I've really sort of refined the apps, so hopefully they continue to do that, so this uses less and less power as we get closer to the final version. And speaking of battery and overall heat, the phone is getting really hot on certain devices. My iPhone 6S Plus, for example, right now is still warm. It's doing absolutely nothing and it's still warm. However, performance does seem to be quite smooth. Performance overall, just using it for the past hour or two, has been really smooth on all these devices, whether that be going into music. This is the first time I've loaded it on this device. We'll wait for it. It's using Wi-Fi, so it could take a moment, but it is warm, so it's using quite a bit of power as well. But you'll see, well, there we go. If we go to our library, it seems to be okay, and scrolling is okay. On the iPhone 11, it's not warm, nor is it warm on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Just the iPhone 6S Plus for me for some reason. So that seems to be a little bit odd, but let's go ahead and take a look at the Geekbench scores to give you a general idea of what to expect, as they seem to be okay. So if we go over to Geekbench, let's find that. You'll see on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, I scored 1,591 for single core, 4,122 for multi-core. So that's pretty good. I didn't run it a second time. I just wanted to let it go. And you'll see prior to that, there's the week before that on the 17th, it's a little bit higher for single core and a little bit lower for multi-core. I would expect this to speed up if I try it again. Now let's take a look at all of these devices. From left to right, I have the 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2021, then the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 11, and then the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Again, this is just to give you a general idea of what to expect from the oldest device to the newest. And so that's everything with iOS 15 Beta 7. I'm looking forward to see what Apple has with the release candidate and when to expect the final version, as I mentioned before. So I think we'll see it in a few weeks, along with hopefully a new Apple event where we'll see iPhone 13 and maybe some surprises as well. I'm really looking forward to that. Let me know what you're looking forward to most in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.